Last Christmas. wasn't their fault. Besides, we're partially to blame. We never visited Uncle Zeke while he was alive.
I don't care. All we got was a measly $100,000 piece, and you made us give it to them.
That's right. They are loaded now, aren't they?
It makes me want to cry every time I think about it.
Oh, Mimi, pack your bags. We're going to the country.
What? No, sir. Not me. Nothing will get me back out to that terrible place.
Not even your own oil field?
Not even my own oil field.
Or what about your own diamond mine? Or a coal mine?
Oswald, please do not tempt me. You know how weak I am for material possessions.
You know, it's the idea of the century. I'm going to call Pete and Petunia and set everything up.
Although coal mines would buy me a lot of merchandise.
Like the Taj Mahal.
Hello?
Pete, pack your bags. We're going on a trip.
A trip? Where? Paris? Egypt?
Cricket County!
Great. I've always wanted to go to Cricket County. Again, but why?
I'll explain everything in the limo, but hurry up, okay?
Oswald, are you sure we have to do this? Can't we just call them on the phone and write them a letter asking if we can please have $1 million worth of oil?
No!
Hello?
Petunia?
Is that Petunia? Give me that phone. Petunia, Oswald wants to go back to that place. Tell him you won't go.
What place? What are you talking about?
You remember the place with the outhouse.
You mean? But why?
Petunia, trust me. It's going to be a very profitable venture. Now hurry up! Okay, I've arranged everything. Oh, and Mimi, try
a
little bit. Be nice to your little cousins this time. Now hurry up!
Back to Cricket County, I don't think I can stand it.
Okay, Brenda, now you just stand right here and me and Brenda May will help you with your lines.
Anybody home?
Golly, Rita Mae, look who
Dear, I don't have much time. Could you please tell them I have stopped by to deliver this document? A condemnation notice. I'm from the local housing commission, and they must be vacated from the premises by December 24th.
Wait a minute. You mean you're throwing them out of their home?
This home, as you call it, has been condemned by the Cricket County Board of Housing. It's a hazard.
Well, it may not be the White House, but it's certainly not hazardous.
According to the standards and regulations set down by the county, this place is a dangerously scary sight to behold.
So is your outfit, but we're not asking
about it. Well, I never.
That's obvious.
This is ridiculous. This house is in perfectly good shape.
Like I said, I have other notices to deliver, so please remind them that they must be out by December 24th. So your papers down with the rest of this room. Oh, it has to stay.
Oswald, can they do that?
It sure looks like it.
But this doesn't make any sense. And what was that? What reason would they have to throw our country cousins out of there?
That was a great imitation of the twins. Can you do it again?
You mean when I say I'll cook up the hell for the collard greens and pork dinners? Yeah, I'll just go fetch that there well water out of that there barn, if we had one. Shoot, all we got is that there outhouse and that cornfield, and that's where I go, where I can hide my stuff. That's some good chewing. Well, 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 look who's here.
Did you just hear what I heard?
I sure did, Linda May.
I can't believe you make fun of my sister that way.
Me? She was making fun of you.
No, she was not making fun of me. She was making fun of you.
Hey, stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!
Mimi, apologize. Stop it! Apologize.
Oswald.
Mimi.
All right, I'm sorry you caught me mocking you.
Mimi.
I'm sorry.
Well, 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 Billy Joe, look what we have here.
Our dear cousin from the city of Pennsylvania City birthday our Christmas play and all.
That's a mighty fine thing of y'all to do.
Me and Glenda May are both the directors.
Yeah, and I wrote the play they're doing.
Say hello to Tennessee Williams for me.
It's about how baby Jesus grew up to be a man who died to forgive other people of their sins.
We call it our forgive and forget play.
That's because when God forgives us of our sins, He forgets about them. Billy Joe wanted me to tell you, he's got a part in the play too.
Aww. And what part do you play?
I hold up the star so the shepherds can follow it to baby Jesus.
Broadway, here you come.
We certainly are looking forward to seeing Billy Joe and Bertha and their forgive and forget play.
Where you been, Cousin Bertha?
That dumb ugly mule got out again.
How does that thing keep getting loose?
Have you been studying your lines?
I'm scared to travel at night.
What?
I'm scared to travel at night.
Honey, have you lost your marbles?
I ain't got no marbles.
She's practicing her lines for the play.
That's the biggest thing I've ever saw.
We're all so proud of our star.
I'm a star, too.
No, you're not a star. You hold a star. There's a difference.
They're both stars. Right, Kate?
Huh? Oh, yeah. Stars.
I reckon it's okay as long as you go first.
Why don't you go and study your lines some more, Bertha?
Yeah, because you already have to be able to sing without your notes tonight. I'm looking at them right now.
Oswald, shouldn't we say something about...
Oh, Brenda May! Glenda May! Wouldn't you like to show the girls something outside?
Huh?
Well, they've never seen the barn. Wouldn't you girls like to see the barn?
No, absolutely not.
Sure you would. While we guys had a little talk.
Oh, we would love to see the barn. Come on, Mimi.
What did I do wrong to deserve this?
Come on, Billy Joe, you can come with us. I'm scared to travel at night.
Bertha, get to the barn with the rest of them.
I'm looking at them right now.
Well, 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 ain't this something? All back together on Christmas. Who would have thunk it?
Okay. We need to talk to you about something. Before you got here, a lady arrived and she left this for you.
She said to make sure you read it.
Oh, shoot. I'll read it later. I want to spend time with my family.
We really feel like you need to read it now. It's a condemnation notice.
Condemnation? That
means they judged your house to be too dangerous to live in and you must move out.
Says who?
Well, they say that the county says you have to be out by Christmas Eve.
Says who?
The county.
But that don't make any sense. Out at Christmas Eve? But where are we going to go?
Okay. Has anybody been up here looking at this? anybody been visiting lately, checking it out?
Not that I know of, cousin.
See, that's what I mean. I think we need to have a little chat with this Miss Basil.
If we don't, then there's not going to be much of a Christmas for you and your family.
Out at Christmas Eve? But I've lived here my whole life. This is my Uncle Zeke's home. His granddaddy's daddy built it for his family.
Oswald! Come quick! Out to the barn!
What is it?
That big wooden building out back!
No! I mean, what's wrong?
Oh! Mimi stood behind the big ugly mule and she kicked her.
What?
Mimi kicked the mule?
Oh, no! The mule kicked Mimi! She's in pain!
Junior, we'll be right there.
Okay.
Listen, cousin. We're going to figure something out. Don't worry.
Look on the bright side. You could always live in the barn.
Pete, don't help.
I hear hay keeps you nice and warm.
Come on, Pete.
Out by Christmas Eve. But where are we going to go? I've never lived anywhere else in my whole life. This ain't good, Gertrude. This ain't good.
Funny in my life.
I just wish we could have been there to see it.
It was worth the trip up here. We really should be laughing
now. Guys, I would really stop laughing if I were you.
I can't help it. I can just imagine the look on her face when she threw the leg.
You know, I've got an idea. Pete, okay. Stand behind me. Ready? Hee-haw! Hee-haw!
Settle down, you old mule. Settle down, Bessie.
Yes, I'm serious.
Oh,
Mimi!
Mimi, have a seat. Are you all right?
I'm glad my injury delights all of you so.
Oh, Mimi, we're sorry. We know you're in pain.
But Brenda May did tell us to not stand behind the mule.
But I was just trying to pet this stupid animal. And I was trying to be civil. And I was trying to be nice.
Well, let this be a lesson to you. When a mule kicks you, don't kick it back.
I think I was going to stand there and be done in by a dumb, ugly animal.
And Michael?
Bertha, just go learn your lines.
I'm scared to try one not.
Bertha, very good. Run along now.
I'm looking at him right now.
Oswald, shouldn't we say something about
Pete? Well, were you able to make any sense of that condemnation notice?
Not much. I'm not even sure it's even legal.
You mean this Miss Basil might not be from the county housing whatever?
Not very likely.
But what reason would she have to throw her country cousins out of their home?
I don't know. I do intend to find out. Where is Oak?
Hopefully shipping that stupid mule to Canada.
He and Billy Joe went to kind of Christmas.
It feels like celebrating Christmas anyways. I say let's con some money out of her stupid cousins and go home.
Mimi, don't use that word while we're here.
What's wrong with the word cousins?
No, the word con. Don't use the word con. If they know we're here to bluff them out of some money, they'll never recover from the hurt.
We can't say con, but we can say bluff.
No, I'm serious. Now listen, we need to play our little parts, say all the right things, and we can walk away with a nice little Christmas bonus. They'll never be the wiser.
Hey, Billy Joe, how are you doing?
Fine, look, I got us a Christmas tree to put up in here. Oh. And I found this.
Billy Joe, hey. How long have you been standing there?
I don't know.
Look, Oswald! He got us a Christmas tree to decorate!
Oswald did not say a word about us this evening.
Pete! It's a lovely tree, Billy Joe.
And look, I found
Elka, good. Come on in and have a seat. We need to talk to you.
Sure thing, cousin. I'd like that. Cousin Mimi, is your leg all right?
Oh, sure. It always feels its best when it's swollen double the normal size.
Elkin, we've got to get to the bottom of this paper that's been started.
You say that nobody's been up here inspecting the place or checking your foundation?
Not since that nice man from New York City was here.
New York City?
Yes'm. He's real friendly like. He come by and said he'd help us get rid of all those oils out there in the fields Uncle Zeke left us for in his will last year.
Cleaned up your oil fields?
Yeah. Told us he'd take a, what they call a pump, and they go in there and they suck all that nasty old oil out of it. He's the most neighborly man I've ever met.
I don't like where this story's going.
Was there money involved?
See, that's the good thing. He didn't charge us one penny to get rid of all that nasty old oil.
Elkin, don't you realize you gave away all your oil fields?
No, I didn't, cousin. We still have the fields. It's the oil that's gone. I figure now we can use it to, you know, grow vegetables in. You know, tomatoes, cucumbers, and the like.
But that man was a swindler, a con artist, a...
Don't forget neighborly.
Well, okay, what about your diamond mine?
Oh, that's where it gets exciting. See, he comes back later, you know, that nice man from New York City. Uh-huh. And he tells us he'd help us get rid of them diamonds, too. And you know what? He got rid of those diamonds, and he didn't charge us, but only
$50. $50? He gave away millions of dollars worth of diamonds, and then he paid them $50.
Didn't have the heart to tell them diamonds weren't worth nothing. See, almonds, they're some good eating, but diamonds, they're hard as a rock. Can't chew them, can't crush them up and put them in a cake. Shoot, Bertha broke two of her teeth trying to chomp down on one of them things.
Oh, well, don't tell me. He came back and cleaned up your coal mines, too.
Okay, I won't tell you.
But he did.
Nicest man in the whole world.
Cousin Elkin, I thought this man was supposed to be coming back up here to get rid of this stuff.
He'll be back, Glenda May. Just be patient.
Oswald, do you see what I see?
It can't be.
Is it what I think it is?
It is. It's
gold!
Uncle Zeke left us some caves out back in the will, you know, to keep the extra animals in.
The way they did in the Bible times.
But the sides of the caves were covered in this yellow shiny rock, and we were afraid that animals might try to lick it off and get it.
They have a gold mine in their backyard.
Elkin, don't you know what this means?
Sure I do, cousin. It means we gotta get rid of all this stuff so the animals don't eat it and get sick.
Oswald, nobody is this dumb.
Elkin, I want you to listen to me. This man is a crook! He stole all of your oil, he stole all of your diamonds, he stole all of your coal, and he's coming back to get your gold!
He is?
Yeah, he only said it would be bad for the animals so that you would let him have it.
Not that time, man.
I don't
think I can breathe. You know, I wonder why he hasn't shown up yet.
If it's that old meal, don't answer it.
Yes? May I please come in?
I told you not to answer it.
Has the owner of this house shown up yet?
I believe this is the man you're wanting to see.
Hello, I'm Miss Basil. I believe you have been thoroughly enlightened of the condemnation notice I have presented previously this fine evening.
That depends.
On what?
On what you just said.
Elkin, this is the lady who told us that you have to move out by Christmas Eve.
Yes, and I don't like small talk, so if you could just sign these papers.
Now, Bertha, I want you to get yourself in here and work on them lines.
But I want to swing on my new swing.
I found her out there playing on the pirate swing.
Bertha.
But we don't have a tire swing.
She made one out of a tire she found.
I can swing real high on it, Cousin Elkin.
You were supposed to be studying your lines.
But I've learned my lines all day.
I can't handle this. I'm going to go check on that old ugly mule.
Brenda May, can't you see that we have a very important visitor?
Oh, yeah. The lady down by the creek bank I saw a while ago. Hey, where's that nice man from New York City?
I don't know what you're talking about. Silly girl, I wasn't with any man.
Sure you was. you remember?
Well, you know how your memory goes when you get old.
Wait a minute, Brenda May. You saw Miss Basil talking to the man from New York City?
She's evidently seeing things. I just drove up in my car.
And I wonder who's all this.
Let me see that.
I'm just going to take that if you don't mind.
I insist you give me that this very minute.
Elton, is this the man from New York City?
Mark Sex. Yeah, that's him.
Billy Dad, you said you found this wallet down at the creek?
Yeah, I saw him drop it. I tried to tell him.
So that's what this is all about. She's working for the swindler.
Pete, let me handle this. So that's what this is all about. She's working with the swindler.
And you came in here with your nose stuck up in the air?
Leave my nose out of this. It's perfect the way it is.
It's the biggest thing I've ever saw.
The donkey! It's gone again!
How'd that thing get loose this time?
Everybody, give me a moment of your attention. Has anyone seen that old, ugly mule?
I'm looking at it right now.
Get away from me, you bucket. I've never been so insulted in my life. Now, I have the condemnation notice right here, and I mean to see that it gets carried out.
Look at me. It's a monster. A creature. How they come to get sick.
I got the paper.
Ma'am.
That was a very naughty thing you done.
But there's gold in those caves, and I want them. And I'll find a way to get them.
Hey!
Oswald!
Mark, start the car! I'm coming!
Ma'am, I wouldn't run behind that mule if I
Ma'am, look
you.
Out! Oh!
Oh, did it again?
Yeah, she's out like a lot.
Well, what about her accomplice? He'll get away.
He can't go far.
What do you mean?
Well, it's hard to get too far on three tires.
What are you talking about?
Well, you remember, I was trying to tell you. Bertha made herself a tire swing. Where do you think she got the tire from?
I took it off with my axe.
Bertha!
Oh, I didn't mean no harm. I just wanted to swing on it.
Bertha, you saved the day.
Yeah, the fox is one tire short on his getaway car, and the old battle axe got stopped by a stubborn old mule.
And let's not forget Gertrude.
Mimi, you're touching the deer.
Oh, no, I'm becoming one of them. Just as he forgave people or forgive other people. Remember,
Billy Joe,
when we see that star every December, let us remember what the Christ child has brought upon us. The end.
Bravo, first one.
You'll do great in the play tomorrow night.
What about me?
Better than any Hollywood actor.
Sorry y'all can't stay to see the real thing.
Well, we've got to get back to the city and get our attorneys working on the fraud case. Maybe we can get your inheritance back.
We don't want to see anybody have to go to jail.
Sure you do. They're thieves.
Maybe we should just forgive them and forget about it.
Can you forgive us, doesn't help again?
We sure like to, Cousin Pete. But is this one of them can forgives and cannot forgives? I'm confused.
So am I.
Yeah, but you forgive people for wearing the same outfit as you, or not inviting you to the important party. I'll be stealing from you.
You mean you're supposed to pick and choose what you're to forgive?
Sure, there. Can forgives and cannot forgives, and this is absolutely a cannot.
Besides, you don't want to forgive these people. They're not worth it.
Don't you understand, Cousin Elkin? They've been bluffing their way to get your money this whole time.
Oh, right. Like you did, right, Cousin Oswald?
Right.
Huh?
Sure, you told Cousin Pete you're here to bluff your way into some money. Don't you remember?
I don't think so.
Sure, you said they're not smart enough to catch on to our scheme. We'll play our little parts, get a nice little Christmas bonus, and move on. They'll never be the wiser.
No. See, what happened,
Is that why you came, Cousin Oswald?
I thought you would have seen me in my Christmas play.
We did. What I mean is, well, you see, alright, fine, we came to get our hands on some of your money. There, I said it.
Golly, if you wanted some money, all you had to do was ask.
Can we have some money?
Elgin, can you ever forgive us again?
Sure thing, cousin. We'll forgive you. And don't you think another thought about it.
You can?
Sure, that's what Christmas is all about. Forgiving and forgetting.
Shoot, that's what this whole play we're doing is all about. Forgiving and forgetting. I sure am glad we can forgive y'all.
Now I put my mind to rest.
Honey, your mind never woke up.
Why is it that we are so educated, but you all are always teaching us something?
Maybe it's because they're educated in the things that really matter.
So, can we forgive Miss Basil, too?
And the cop man from New York City?
Okay, you can forgive the thieves.
Yeah!
But they still have to go to jail.
Aww.
Besides, if they don't, they'll just do the same thing to someone else.
You know, Elgin, I've got an idea. Why don't all of you come to the city and spend the New Year with us? Our way of saying we're sorry for what we did.
You mean us go to the city?
Sure. We'll show you the finest metropolis your eyes shall ever behold.
Thanks, Cousin Pete. But we'd rather see the city.
Cousin Mimi, do you have a house as big as this one?
Honey, my closet's bigger than this house.
Oswald, shouldn't we be going?
We'll have the limo come and pick all of you up. Until then, Merry Christmas, country cousins.
Merry Christmas, city cousins.
Mimi?
Huh?
What's in your bag?
It's some frog liver jelly, of course. I'm taking it back home to Mommy.
Are you sure that's all you have?
Don't look at me that way. Let's go.
Mimi, watch out for the
mule! No! Oh.
I want to apologize for her.
It's okay, cousin. We'll forgive you.
Yes, you do a lot of that, don't you?
Goodbye again.
Billy Joe, what are you doing?
Making sure baby Jesus stays warm.
I sure am glad we could forgive everybody, cousin.
Me too. Everybody, remember, when Billy Joe holds up this here star tomorrow night and Bertha plays the shy little shepherd, that we remember the true reason for this season. It's about the birth of a baby that would grow up to be a man to die for our sins to forgive us.
Elkin, you said that real good. You should be a preacher.
Yeah, that way you can marry me and Cousin Oswald when we go to the city.
Bertha, it's getting dark. How about you go outside and cut us up some firewood?
I'm scared of traveling night.
Oh, yeah? How would you like a knuckle sandwich?
The biggest thing I've ever saw.
And walk around that mule. You don't want to get kicked, do you?
I reckon it's okay as long as you go first.
Guess who the the biggest nitwit in the world is.
I'm looking at it right now.
I'll beat you for that.
She'll give birth to a son, and she's given the name Jesus because he'll forgive the people of their sins.
It's the biggest thing I've ever saw.
Bertha!
Merry Christmas, y'all. You come back now, you hear?
Her watch, he even knows what time it is.
It's
a real train deer. This morning, if you didn't get anything from it, yesterday evening, I got home and I started thinking about how good God is. Pastor Lawrence, we have prayer every Sunday morning. He gave me a word this morning. How many's ever been weak? Lift up your hands this morning. Let me ask you this. How many's ever been distracted? You had so much going on you couldn't focus. Lift up your hand. Pastor Lawrence said, Mark, how many times have you ever been just frustrated? Lift up your hand. And it brought one when he said the next sentence, I remember somebody here on a Sunday night giving that word. And he said, when the enemy comes in and we get weak and we get distracted and we lose our focus, the first thing that happens is we quit praising. When we quit praising, the enemy moves closer into our life to where we don't make spiritual decisions anymore. We make our own mental decisions. You know, this morning, if you could get anything from this play, it was number one, to forgive. Aren't you glad that God forgives?
Amen.
The second thing I thought was, is love. Boy, if somebody here today tried to steal off you, I'm sure you wouldn't be like the cousin. We forgive you. Why? Because we start thinking mentally. But this morning, the thing that I want to ask you is this. Have you lost your praise? Have you been weak? Have you been distracted? Because there's a God that's here today. And as He held up that star, what are you following today? Have you ever thought about what you're following? You know, there's people all across our nation that follows not a star, but a dollar sign. Because they say, well, if I can get as much money in my account, I'm going to be the happiest person in the world. I can take you to a woman and a man right now. Their checkbook will not run dry. I will promise you. I made this story. And they said when they first got married, they were the happiest people that they had ever been in their life. Because all they did was live in a single wide trailer, and they were happy. You say, Mark, where are you getting that? Jesus Christ was born in a stable. Not in a hospital room, not in a clean room, but in a stable. Shepherds come from way afar to come and see this child because that child was going to change somebody's life. I don't know about you today, but who's here today that would love to have a change in their life today? I'm not asking you to be saved. What I'm asking you is, if Jesus is not in your life, what are you relying on? What are you relying on? There's a family that's here, and there's another family that's here. And the one family I want to talk about is her, their mother was the one person when I got called into the ministry that said, I'm going to be praying for you from this day forward. I remember putting my head in her lap the last time I went and seen her. And this is what she told me. She said, as long as I've got Jesus Christ,
The devil can't steal what God's got for me. She lived her life every day to give God the praise and honor. This morning, if you're here, I want to give you an opportunity. I want to give you two opportunities this morning. Number one, to be able to, when I ask you to stand, to be able to come out and kneel at an altar and say, God, I want to thank you for my family. I want to thank you, God, for supplying my needs. I want to thank you, God, for when I have failed you or not prayed or not even acknowledged you today. God, you kept my son or my daughter safe today. But I want to give you another opportunity. If you don't know who Jesus is, to come to an altar and say, God, I want you to be in my life. I want a present that money can't buy. My mom uses this saying all the time. I'll say, what do you want? She said, I want what money can't buy. Church, you're at the right place today. This is better than Walmart. So I'm going to ask everybody to stand if you will this morning.